Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask you to please rise, remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem.
And good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back for the final time to IMG Academy Field in Bradenton, Florida for this, the 2016 IMG Cup consolation match between Team USA and their Under-17 Development Academy taking on FC Florida Prep Academy tonight. The USU-17s will be wearing their black jerseys with red and blue shoulders with white numerals. I believe they'll be going left to right to start in the first half. FC Florida Prep Academy wearing their baby or Carolina blue jerseys and shorts with white numerals. Again, they will be attacking from the south goal on your right to the north goal on the left of your screen. Starters, some changes for the U.S. men's under 17 squad compared to what they had last night against the Tottenham Hotspur. In goal again will be Justin Garces, also defender Arturo Vasquez. Forward, Ayamide Akinola. Forward, Josh Sargent. Forward, Andrew Carlton. And then defender, Carlos Asensio. Defender, Carlo Rattaccio. Midfielder, Akil Watts. Midfielder, Isaac Anking. Defender, Chandler Vaughn. And midfielder, Adrian Villegas. Starting for FC Florida Prep Academy in goal will be number one, Alexander Wesley. And defender, number three, Sawyer Reese. Defender number five, LJ Lemmers. Midfielder number six, Christopher Textor. Midfielder slash forward number seven, Isaiah Lobos Trujillo. Midfielder number nine, Sabino Lozano. Midfielder number 12, Dennis Cabrera. Defender number 18, Evensky Berlus. Midfielder number 24, Kareem Florville. And defender number 30, Clark Mortel. And defender number 32, Clark Petrov. The head coach for FC Florida Academy is Jelko Petrov. And the head coach for your USU 17 team is Marcelo Serrano. And we are underway to start. And right now, Team USA kind of still in that funk from yesterday's 3-1 loss to now eventual champions, the Tottenham Hotspur Youth Academy. My name is Ryan Sudol, my broadcast partner, Trevor DeGroat. And Trevor, is there anything you think that the U.S. needs to work on? Obviously, having lost to the champions for the 2016 IMG Cup that we didn't maybe see from them last night.
Well, one thing in particular is ball possession. Tottenham did an excellent job of keeping the ball for the most part of that entire match, and very similar to what they did just now to Toluca just a few moments ago, winning the championship. That's exactly what they did. So the United States, his main mission is ball possession and keeping it in Florida Academy's end.
Again, don't forget you can interact with us on social media at IMG Academy as well as at events at IMGA. Also, don't forget use the hashtag IMG Cup 2016. It's been a fun week of competition here, not just in the supergroup, Trevor, the games that we've seen, but also just amongst the other 150-plus teams that have come down to Bradenton, Florida for this fun annual tournament.
Yeah, spectacular events that draws a huge crowd amongst these amongst the people here in Bradenton, but of course the visiting clubs as well, and spread out on these 15 or so odd fields that IMG has. A great landscape of fields and great tournament play that we've seen this year in the IMG Cup Invitational.
Now Carlton looking for the through ball, trying to find Chandler Vaughn coming up that right wing. Again, number 16 for Team USA, Akeel Watts, also one of the IMG Academy products, was also listed on their roster for their U18 developmental squad, but here and dressed and in the starting 11 for the Baby Yanks. Pressure coming from FC Florida Prep. That is Clark Mortel. Up through the midfield, he was looking for Dennis Cabrera and settled down for USA. And the stands at IMG Academy Field last night completely packed for the match against the Tottenham Hotspur Academy in one of the most well-known Premier League academies in England and has developed some fantastic talent, and it was on display here for the last week.
And they certainly earned their championship. They executed their game plan to perfection against Toluca in this championship game and really just had their way with most of the teams, including Team USA, Saturday night.
Anking looking for Akinola, but excellent defense. Now back forward. Anking into the box, cuts back, tries to get a left-footed shot off. Instead, it's cleared away.
I guess Anking didn't really like the angle he was at. Probably was hoping for a quick little bounce back towards his left to maybe have more room and more net to look at. Did not pull the trigger, and it cost him.
So far, Team USA has been fairly dominant in their attacking half this early going, just in the fourth minute of play, but have not seen FC Florida Preparatory Academy maintain much possession or be able to move the ball forward past midfield. Sargent up to Akinola, entering the top of the 18-yard box. First touch, fantastic by Adrian Villegas. And then finally cleared back upfield, trying to get the ball up for Lobos Trujillo. And the USU 17 team regained possession. You can see now FC Florida Preparatory Academy looking for Trujillo. Drops it off to his left, and now Carlos Asensio, another one of the Atlanta United Academy products for the USU 17 Youth Academy. Anking with pressure on, looking forward. Gets it to Sargent. Sargent was instrumental in setting up the lone goal against Tottenham last night, setting up George Acosta, as that throw-in will stay with the U.S. That is Akeel Watts up for Carlton. Carlton tries to cut back. Great defense by Sabino Lozano. U.S. still keep the ball on the front foot. Beautiful turn by Anking. Out wide for Sargent. Booted away. The throw will stay and possession with the United States. Akinola up for Sargent, tries to get the cross up and through. Instead, it's out for a U.S. corner kick.
Well, thus far, this is our first true look at getting a chance to see Florida Prep Academy in action. They had a tough time getting the ball and also trying to get it out into the other end of the field. Haven't been able to build anything yet. The United States has been all possession for them. Let's see if they can strike.
With with the in-swinger. Going towards the far post, headed away safely. And back out by Akinola. Cuts it back for Andrew Carlton. And Carlton taken down just outside, about 15 yards outside the midfield circle. Quick restart, Villegas up for Sargent, and Sargent just waits his pass a little off. Now Trujillo, strong tackle. They're going to whistle Carlo Rattaccio for the foul, and FC Florida Prep Academy will have an opportunity to put on a little pressure to the U.S. back line. And now the interception. Akinola in a dead sprint. Drops it off for Anking in the box, poked away. And a last-second move by Clark Petrov to set that out for a corner kick and avoid the U.S. going up 1-0.
A lot of penetration by the United States. A lot of runs ahead, mainly by Anking. He's getting close.
Anking gets under with the in-swinger. Headed back out of the box. Pressure coming. FC Florida Prep tries to clear it away. Nice header. Villegas fighting for possession. He is taken down. And Villegas, part of the Portland Timbers Youth Academy from Hood River, Oregon. One advantage that the FC Florida Prep Academy has, it's just about a year more of experience. Everybody in FC Florida Prep born in either 1999 or 98. Everybody on the U.S. U17 roster born in the year 2000. And a free kick whistled, no advantage played.
And yet what you can notice is that the United States, and it's probably not surprising, they're a little bigger than FC Florida Prep. But the Academy is probably going to have to do some penetrating. What we've noticed so far, anytime they've gotten the ball and it's been deep in their own end, they've seemed to keep everybody back. And then they've tried to move the ball to Trujillo up top, maybe bring the attacking midfielders up later on, maybe to the wings is probably what their strategy is. Haven't seen it put into effect just yet. Trujillo's had some difficulty with the U.S. defense and the midfielders who have been on him when he has gotten the ball near midfield.
Great pass for Akinola going into that far left corner. Taken away by FC Florida. Villegas gets a touch to it and up and out. Throw-in. This will be Evenski Berlus. Again, approaching 8 o'clock local time. We've been blessed over the past week with some fantastic weather on the Gulf Coast of Florida. Sargent with the takeaway into the box. Carlton tries to get a volley, but out for a goal kick. 11th minute of play, still scoreless. Again, those of you just now tuning in, Tottenham Hotspur able to defeat Deportivo Toluca by a score of 2-0 to win the 2016 IMG Cup Championship. And their second championship in 4 years. The other 2 years that they did not win it, they were runners-up, including last year, 2015, when they lost to the Israeli Premier League side Maccabi Haifa. Now throw it forward for Trujillo, and Justin Garces able to scoop, no fear for the U.S. national team and their under-17 squad, which has shown some promise. Talked about some of their recent international successes, the Nike International Friendlies. Villegas up forward, this one for Chandler Vaughn, into the box, gets the cross through and just missing Villegas, but the second attempt, it's Akinola with the U.S. goal! Ayamide Akinola, an excellent trailer as the initial pass. Again, Chandler Vaughn was trying to find Adrian Villegas right in front of the net. Akinola able to get the strong shot, just sneaking it inside that far post.
You cannot forget about the backside. That is the biggest thing. As a defense, you obviously want to make sure the get man with the ball doesn't get too far deep, which is what Vaughn was able to do. He got as far as he possibly could towards the end line, and his initial pass, yes, was for Villegas. Instead, however, as we saw, Akinola was coming in at the last second, fired it on net. The U.S. with a 1-0 lead.
And before that goal, we were talking about some of the recent international successes. Back at the Nike International Friendlies, just about 10 miles down State Road 70 here in Bradenton, Florida, taking on the Brazilian, the Turkish, and the Portuguese under 17 national teams. Portugal sending some of their reserve players, but still, the U.S. men's national team under 17s were able to win by 7-1 over them, 5-1 over the Turkish national team, and then Brazil with a lot of their future stars and a lot of their first team players for the U17s. The U.S. was able to win 3-0, a tournament which is what just a few years ago launched new U.S. sensation Christian Pulisic into the forefront, now playing for the Bundesliga side Borussia Dortmund, as well as the U.S. men's senior team. Great collapsing defense from the back line. The U.S. able to win possession back. Villegas. Now for Vaughn. Chandler Vaughn, one of two members of the DC United Academy on this team. And the takeaway, and they're going to call Carlson for the foul. Now Trujillo lines up a shot and just tracking wide as Garces and out for the goal kick, but a nice effort by Isaias Lobos Trujillo. And this is also a great showcase. A lot of college coaches coming down to this tournament now having their seasons concluded to scout some future talent, not necessarily from the men's national team side, but some of the other academies that come down and participate in this tournament. It's a great way to scout some future talent at the NCAA level. Approach 8 o'clock local time, again just in the Gulf Coast of Florida. Relatively a muggy night, a lot warmer than it was last night, 74 degrees. Those of you tuning in from all over the country, hopefully not caught in that polar vortex as the Sarasota-Bradenton area has not been affected. Carlton taken down, advantage being played. Akinola dropping back for Villegas. Now up into the box looking for Anking. And out for a goal kick.
The United States employing the through ball very, very nicely. They haven't had to go over the top at all to generate the pressure. For Florida Academy, they're going to have to think of something here. The United States is pretty big. They're very, very fast. They may have to outthink and possibly outmaneuver Team USA to have more chances.
And Now sent forward, up looking for Chandler Vaughn. Cuts it back for Carlton, and he is taken down, and that should be the last talking to that number six. Christopher Textor will be getting a very blatant foul, tugging on the shoulder of number 11, Andrew Carlton. Now they just misplayed a little bit of a run, and now into the box and just into the hands of Wesley Alexander. And it looks like that may have been, as frustrated as Carlton may have looked on camera, looks like that might have been a designed play to try and throw them off. Again, as Anking tried to cross that in toward the far post.
Well, it certainly seemed like it, because you had three Yanks all alone right there in front of Alexander, and it was Arturo Vasquez who got the foot on the ball, and he got absolutely denied. A great save. But it is all USA, 18 minutes in, having their way with Florida Prep.
Last night against Tottenham, Sergeant Carlton, as well as Akinola up top, showed some promise early on before Tottenham was just able to kind of run away with the game. Trujillo. Great touch, overlapping run by Textor. And U.S. right there to close in on it. They're going to say it was out. And it'll be a throw-in for the U.S. in the 19th minute.
Florida Prep's just going to have to be very, very fast with the ball. The United States is too quick to try and set anything too dramatic up. They're just going to have to move that ball fast, be very diligent, protective, but also thorough in work in trying to get their offensive game plan to work to their liking.
Now Garces, and one of the better keepers in that 16-year-old range, has very great command of the box. The switch looking for Clark Mortel. Back to the west side of the field. Now up forward looking for Textor again, running down that left wing. But nothing doing, and back to Garces. Anking looking for an outlet. Garces looking for a teammate. Finds one down the far side. And now has Akinola with space to run. Dropped off for Asensio. Villegas up to Anking. Back to Villegas. And out wide to Chandler Vaughn. Nice turn by Villegas. We're dropping back. Again, the U.S. now trying to build in their attacking third. Carlton misplays it, and a takeaway for FC Florida Prep. Out wide, crossing chance. Put it into the box and safely headed away. Again, number 15, Carlo Ritaccio. And then a volley from about 35 yards out. Again, if you don't shoot, you can't score. And a nice attempt by number three, Sawyer Reese.
Well, that'll certainly get some college scouts' attention. From downtown, quite a good power stroke right there.
Keel Watts fighting for it, and Carlton touches back up to Akinola.
And it was certainly Florida Prep's best rush that they've had in this game.
Anking just outside of the 18-yard box. Setting it up for Carlton, and goal-saving slide tackle by Sawyer Reese, and out for a corner kick.
Very good plays right there by Mr. Reese.
And the short corner to Anking. Now back to Carlton. Just outside the 18-yard box, and now back for Trujillo. bodies off Asensio. Fought for, and now Trujillo wanting a foul call, doesn't get it. Carlton and Villegas, and now set up. And again, it's Josh Sargent, but beautiful save by Wesley Alexander. Sargent's got it again, tries to sneak it through, and the defenders recover for FC Florida Prep to keep this just a one-goal game.
Alexander's probably already had a game and a half of how many saves and big-time moments he's had. Florida Prep's going to have to do a much better job of defending that, and they can't get beat in these one-on-one matchups. That's what's killing them, amongst other things. But right there, you saw Sargent able to recover after not getting the shot off the first time.
Short corner again. Up top, Villegas lines up a shot from about 20 yards. Sargent can't give chase on that one as he was offside, so instead it'll go back to Wes Alexander.
Nice job by Kerry and Florville right there. That's the kind of defensive pressure that Prep's going to have to employ. Don't want to let the United States have all day to shoot.
Akil Watts fighting for possession, able to win it back and drop it back for Carlton. Now Carlton breaks through the midfield. A nice little 15-yard run. Sargent. Space up top of the 18. Tries to feed it through for Villegas. Florida Prep Academy. Again, starting to tighten down. Sent wide by Kareem Florville. Through the legs of Chandler Vaughn, but one back by the U.S. And IMG Academy also the home to a lot of former World Cup participants for the United States senior team. Tim Howard, known to train here, has a lot of family in the Bradenton area, as well as his former goalkeeping coach for the U.S. national team, Tim Mulqueen, who's an athletic director at a local area high school. I believe it's St. Stephen's Episcopal. DeMarcus Beasley, other names, Freddie Adu. A lot of, again, former players that have shined on a national stage. As FC Florida Prep now into the 18-yard box. And then taken away quickly by Asensio. But it's finally starting to get some attacking chances. Back into the midfield circle. Cabrera and Florville trading possession, and now Akinola already with one goal. Takes some contact. Able to play a little keep away through that midfield. And Villegas settles it back to the U.S. defense.
Very smart right there, knowing he had three Carolina blue jerseys around him. Decided to err on the side of caution and work the ball back to a safe spot to maintain possession.
Sent forward and just pass Wes Alexander and out for a goal kick.
Yeah, Florida Prep not really, doesn't appear to be in sync right now. Their players aren't exactly in cohesion right now. Gonna have to find some way to be more precise on these passes. A lot of them have missed their mark.
Now the cross, going toward the far post, looking for the head of Anking. He gets to it, but Alexander able to keep it out of the back of his net. Another great chance for the U.S. and a strong save and a good performance by Wesley Alexander. Now the foot race between Ratacio and Trujillo.
Anking was in very good position on that header. Just couldn't get all of it.
Take away by Textor. up forward and a chance-saving foot stuck out by number 15, Carlo Rattaccio. Otherwise, Textor was going to be in beautiful position to line one up, and now Carlton takes a shot. The effort from 30 yards, well wide, and out for the goal kick. U.S. Now switch back to the near side and Rattaccio. Josh Sargent, first touch, looking for Akil Watts, overlapped by Anking, and now looking for Akinola in the box. He gets there, tries to sneak it through and cleared away by FC Florida Prep. Rattaccio needing to recover quickly. Trujillo trying to get by one. Now into the middle. Again, Villegas trying to keep it away from Florville. And then sent back upfield by Vaughn. Akinola trying to get through three FC Florida Prep midfielders, unsuccessful, but the U.S. able to recover and reset their defense. And Villegas with an elbow to the back. And Anking trying to halt play. He'll have a talking to.
Well, thus far, it's been more of a finesse match compared to the championship game where we heard the whistle blow many, many times and many cards get dished out. So far, for the most part, everyone on their best behavior in this consolation game.
I think as the 80 minutes goes through, as now Sargent has the takeaway. It's him and Carlton. Now Carlton up top, trying to get around one. Tries to drop it back through for Sargent. Beautiful leave, but diving to his left is Alexander before Josh Sargent can put a foot to it. And it stays a 1-0 game. U.S. still with the momentum, but FC Florida Prep Academy showing signs of life.
Just a little bit too close towards the goal. A little more east-west. Probably would have had a shot. But yes, indeed, Florida Prep's starting to get a few things go their way. Starting to open up, and they're trying to get quicker on the attack. Still, though, they haven't been too close to a goal. The only one that was very close of happening was Textor coming in on that feed just a few moments ago.
Take away by Lemmers, but settled back down by Rattaccio. Anking in the box, and he is going to be awarded the penalty kick. Shoved down just inside, a yellow card is shown. And number 20, Isaac Anking, is approaching the spot. We'll see who takes it. I believe Anking wants it.
Evenski Berlus is the guilty party here. A simple bump in the back, a little overzealous. And that's going to be the things that FC Florida is definitely not going to want to have to do. It's already tough enough going up against the U.S. men's team that's put on a pretty good performance thus far, but to give them a free penalty kick, that's your worst nightmare.
And now Wesley Alexander, the true test, Isaac Anking, trying to put the U.S. U17 team up 2-0. On the approach, a quick one, tries to do it, and Alexander with the save! Anking tries to go to his left. Wesley Alexander dives to his right. And just an incredible job by number one for FC Florida Prep.
Well, let's see if that can supercharge Florida Prep into getting an offensive attack. Wesley Alexander has certainly had the yeoman's share of the workload here for his team, and he's only kept it a 1-0 game. So far, a fantastic showcase by him.
At one of those situations where you would say the soccer gods have spoken, as FC Florida Prep Academy was trying to plead their case that it was not a foul in the box. They do not concede the penalty kick goal.
And what made that more impressive by Alexander is that Anking really didn't give any tell. He kind of waited well after the referee blew the whistle, saying, okay, yeah, you can go ahead and kick. He took several seconds before he went and then just sprung into action. But Alexander stayed very patient and guessed right.
Trujillo fighting for it. Kept in, finds Sabino Lozano. Into the 18-yard box, lining up a shot. And Justin Garces able to knock it down to the pitch and keep it out of the back of his net in the 33rd minute.
Good give and go by Florida Prep right there. Trujillo, now on the opposite side, Alexander on defense, he's had a big workload. It's Trujillo who's trying to be the spark plug on offense. He's trying to get some goals scored.
Now Carlton looking for Akinola.
And Trujillo's already had a long time of running, and he's had to battle for some balls right here as you see him try and get it. Put some pressure on as well. He's running around a lot.
Ritaccio sends it back toward the FC Florida Prep goal and knifing through, looking for Akinola, but he is offside. Carlton was trying to set him up, just got his toe under it, and Akinola a step too fast, and offside is whistled.
And Carlton's showing incredible speed through the center of the field, carving his way up. Akinola just a little hasty. Just a few feet, maybe a couple inches offside.
Headed back for Garces as the first half continues to wind down. Again, if you did not have an opportunity to tune in earlier or last night, only play 40 minutes at the IMG Cup. And now a beautiful through ball for Akinola. Tries to leave it off, looking for Vaughn. He lines up a shot from just outside of the 18-yard box. Now Sargent getting a leg to it and able to recover. Textor. Pressure coming by Akil Watts. Nice takeaway by Sargent. Very good as a field general with the ball at his feet, especially up in the middle. And now looking for the through ball. Villegas and Akinola trading passes and back to Andrew Carlton. Looks like Carlton may have dropped back to a more midfield position, as opposed to playing up top, which is what we've been more accustomed to seeing in the past few weeks. And they will whistle offside. Not sure if, in fact, he was. I believe that was Anking down the far left wing. So a free kick coming for FC Florida Prep. Throw-in for the USU-17s. Asensio receives, and now it is Ritaccio up through the midfield circle, and now Carlton back to Asensio. Exchanging with Anking, who now takes it up to Akinola for Villegas. And trying to drop it off for Josh Sargent, but intercepted. Dennis Cabrera. Watts back to Asensio.
And just when Florida Prep gets the ball, it's just the United States pounces right back, 11 men on defense. Very, very impressive getting the ball right back.
Akinola whistled for the foul. And headed back for Garces. Scoops it safely, beginning in the 38th minute. U.S. U-17's up 1-0 after the 12th minute goal scored by Ayamide Akinola. Had an opportunity for a penalty a few minutes ago and stopped by Wesley Alexander after Anking was taken down in the box. Sargent fighting for it. And they will whistle Clark Mortel for the foul. Akinola gets by one. Beautiful touch, tripped up. Set up for Akil Watts, cuts back, and a beautiful slide tackle by Clark Mortel to set it back to Wesley Alexander.
Mortel and Sawyer Reese are the two main center backs back there. Have to do a pretty tough job tonight.
Watts up for Carlton. Keeps possession, towed away. And it will stick with the USU-17s. Josh Sargent gets the throw into Akinola. And Rattaccio able to avoid the quick counter by FC Florida Prep. Advantage being played. Villegas keeps possession. Now settling it back down just outside the midfield circle and back into the U.S. half. Akinola looking for space to turn. Finds Akil Watts on the near side. And a beautiful move to get by one. Akinola trying to get a nice outside foot pass into the box, still kept in by Asensio. Watts with the turn and back looking for the give and go with Watts. Instead, it will trickle into the corner. Now, looking for Anking back in the box again is Sargent. Instead, it's cleared back and safely out for FC Florida Prep Academy for the time being.
Well, the U.S. is still getting pretty deep, probably more so than what Florida Prep would have to their liking.
Watson, Anking, both onside, into the box looking for, looks like that was Chandler Vaughn. Wesley Alexander again making the save. As we wind down the first half.
This Florida Prep backline, though, is getting better, it seems, as the game's going on, of actually sticking with the likes of Akinola and these U.S. attacking players.
1 minute of stoppage time shown on the fourth official's board. On the counter looking for Textor. Nice turn by Textor as he takes down Akil Watts. Akinola stays with it after going down to the pitch, able to get by one, gets by another. Instead, it's safely booted away by Evenski Berlus. Chandler Vaughn, and now into the boxes. Carlton looking for Anking, who was offside. And now the center referee going to have some words with Trujillo.
Didn't quite see what happened, but Trujillo, of course, has been battling with the U.S. midfielders and defenders all night long, so he's probably expressing a few bits of frustration.
going to let FC Florida Prep maybe have one more, and that is going to end the first half. Difference in the game right now, the Iamide Akinola 12th minute goal to put the U.S. up 1-0. But the story of the game so far, Trevor, has to be Wesley Alexander for FC Florida Prep.
Yeah, I think Florida Prep is lucky to only be down 1-0. Coming in with some incredible stops on some rushes and, of course, denying the penalty kick earlier on in the game. So he has certainly played well worth his fair share of play tonight. He's done a fantastic job in net. He's kept his team in it. And we'll see if Florida Prep can somehow find and decipher a way to get behind this U.S. defense. It's been tough so far. Haven't had too many chances. But if they want to come out victorious and at least first get the equalizer, that's exactly what they're going to have to do.
That's Trevor DeGroat. I'm Ryan Sudol. We'll have second half action for you in 15 minutes. You are watching the 2016 IMG Cup consolation game presented by Stream Sports.
Sometimes great vacations aren't about what you get, but more about what you get to leave behind. This is your invitation to pull the plug. Let it all go and get in touch with what really matters. In a place where life is simpler and the memories last forever. Real authentic Florida. Bradenton, Anna Maria Island, Longboat Key. Plan to visit online at bradentongulfislands.com.
Everyone wants to be the first one in and the last one out. Me, I'm no different. It's no badge of honor. It's just because when I'm here, you're not. When I'm here, you're not. And when I'm here, you're not.
Be the best, so does everybody else. See, it takes more than wanting it. You gotta show up. And when you show up and camp here, you'll be ready to compete anywhere. We'll be right back. Here, at IMG Academy, we rise each day with one rival, ourselves. Perfecting our practice to outdo what's been done. Because we know the spotlight is stolen after the light runs out. Here, we study more than scouting reports. Here, no stat can ever measure our potential. And the way we see it, podiums are mere stepping stones. Our repetition creates separation. And those in search of shortcuts need not apply. Because in our school of thought, luck comes to those who earn it. This is IMG Academy. We are the Ascenders. And we are on the rise. Everybody wants to be the best, but it takes more than wanting it. You gotta show up, and when you show up and camp here, you'll be ready to compete anywhere. Everyone wants to be the first one in and the last one out. Me, I'm no different. It's no badge of honor. It's just because when I'm here, you're not. When I'm here, you're not. And when I'm here, you're not. Be the best, so does everybody else. See, it takes more than wanting it. You gotta show up, and when you show up and camp here, you'll be ready to compete anywhere.
Vacations aren't about what you get, but more about what you get to leave behind. This is your invitation to pull the plug. Let it all go and get in touch with what really matters. In a place where life is simpler and the memories last forever. Real authentic Florida. Bradenton, Anna Maria Island, Longboat Key. Plan to visit online at bradentongulfislands.com.
We got a win tonight since the Giants won,
so we can't drop another one.
Good luck with the doorknob, dude. Congrats on the new phone.
Usually, U.S. soccer does the opposite of what MLS does, which is funny.
Good evening and welcome back to IMG Academy Field, getting ready for second half action in the 2016 IMG Cup consolation match between the US U17s and FC Florida Prep Academy. A couple substitutions for the U.S. coming on in the second half. Defender number 3, Christopher Gloucester. Midfielder number 6, Chris Durkin. As well as midfielder number 8, Blaine Ferry. And midfielder number 26, Chris Goslin. Your three up top, Akinola, Sargent, and Carlton still on the pitch. So just a little bit of a shakeup at midfield. Looks like Asensio, Rattaccio, and Akil Watts may be done for the day. And for the second half, again, U.S. in their black kits, white numerals going right to left or south to north directionally on your screen. And the story of the first half. Absolutely, Wesley Alexander, the keeper for FC Florida Prep Academy, making a few saves and key points, including a penalty kick that was taken by Anking.
It was a dominant offensive performance for the most part by the United States. They've pretty much had their way in keeping it in Florida Prep's end. But as you said, Alexander's done his job, keeping the damage to a minimum.
Now Carlton tries to get that one into the box, instead back into the hands of Wes Alexander. A nice corner kick set up by Chris Gloucester. And a fairly clean first half for the most part. Just a couple of stern referee talking twos, and now Sargent into the box and into the back of the net. A beautiful through ball. Josh Sargent finds his way to stay onside. Absolutely incredible pitch vision, and puts the U.S. up 2-0 in the 42nd minute.
Just a fantastic job of getting behind the back four for Florida Prep. Too much green grass with them as well, catching them off guard. And unfortunately for Alexander, not much he can do there. A very tough task already for him tonight. The United States coming out of the gates of this second half, exactly what they wanted to do. Continuing it on, and now they have a 2-0 lead.
Beautiful run, just been waiting for Sargent to break through. Mentioned earlier, he set up the goal to number 10, George Acosta, last night. And now he's got one of his own in this tournament. Been in fantastic form going back to those Nike International friendlies. And now Trujillo has one to beat for FC Florida Prep. Beautiful step over and excellent defense taken away by number 6, Chris Durkin. Another one of the DC United products on this US U17 team.
A lot of it has been asked by Trujillo tonight. Florida Prep utilizing that 4-2-3-1. Trujillo being that lone attacker for them at the top of their formation. A lot expected out of him, but he can't do it alone, especially when this US team can get back on track and fall back real quickly.
Foster back to Goslin. Looking for Anking down the right wing. Instead, it's a touchdown for a throw. Sargent, beautiful give and go on the turnaround, but this time, offside whistled against the U.S. men's national under 17 team. To Garces. Yeah. Durkin looking for that deep ball down the right wing. Great first touch. Cutting through again, that is Chandler Vaughn. Now into the box looking for Sargent again, just missing his head. Will be touched out for a goal kick.
Just too many lapses in the defense right now for Florida Prep. Another open yank down the side right there. And towards the end of the first half, they were starting to keep pace. But right now, for the first 5 minutes, not the case at all.
Goslin being called for the foul. FC Florida Prep going to try to reset, build from the back. And just out pass touch for Textor.
Yeah, that pressure is really getting to Florida Prep's defense. The United States giving chase very, very nicely, forcing them to make passes that they don't exactly have the time for, or they haven't exactly located yet, causing some interruptions and errant mistakes.
Akinola there with that lead pass, thinking that he was going to have Rattaccio down that right wing, was able to realize that nobody was trailing for it and recovered with his speed. Beautiful touch by Carlton, but he goes down and he is in pain. Now Gloucester into the corner. Stays with it. FC Florida Prep trying to get it back through Anking. Assistant referee says it stays in. Anking into the box, gets the cross and tries to take the hard angle. It'll be a throw-in, and I think Carlton may need a substitute.
You see him limping right there on that left leg.
It looks like he may have just given his head coach a thumbs up. Banking wins possession back. And Blaine Ferry. Back for Akinola and Goslin. Carlton seems to have recovered nicely. Back to a full sprint, a beautiful dummy. Now down into the box. Another opportunity for the U.S. and Chandler Vaughn. Tries to sneak one by Wesley Alexander, but as he's been all night, that was another fantastic save.
Beautifully executed dummy, as you said, Ryan. And once again, the United States just not really having any difficulties getting in deep. They're not being challenged particularly hard by Florida Prep. They have to amp up the pressure. They want to hold off the baby Yanks.
Very out wide. Gloucester. Touch through looking for Carlton, and then finally cleared away by FC Florida Prep. Substitution now coming on for FC Florida Prep Academy. Looks like it will be a number 11, Gabriel Almeida, coming in for Sabina Lozano. U.S. with a throw deep in their attacking half. Into the box for Sargent. Unable to get that first touch that he was looking for. It bounces up, deflects off his chest, and out of play. Takeaway, Trujillo in space. Tries to get by Goslin, unable. Akinola, nice step over. Again, Chandler Vaughn running through and can't get up past that pass from Akinola. As Blaine Ferry now gets the pass through a defender's legs. Akinola fighting towards the top of the 18. Anking goes down. And I believe it's number 20, Isaac Anking, getting called for the foul. You can also hear his displeasure with that particular call.
Yeah, it looked like he got the cleats up just slightly. Anytime you bring your cleats up and it causes a disruption to the opposing player, that more than likely will draw out a yellow.
Gloucester with the first touch. FC Florida Prep able to keep possession. Josh Sargent putting on some deep pressure. Akinola fighting through a few defenders, able to get it back. Nice turn. Sargent in the box, and they're going to say no foul. Center referee right there, and you can hear the groans from some of the members of the crowd.
That was Clark Petroff putting on that pressure.
And then rolled right back to Justin Garces to keep this a 2-0 game in favor of the U.S. U-17 team, looking to take third place in this IMG Cup competition. Durkin back through to Goslin. Ferry brings it in through the midfield circle, takes a couple unfavorable bounces, and now a retaliatory flag, and the referee issues that with some authority. That to Dennis Cabrera, no doubt after just having that last talking to. So in the 52nd minute, we'll see Dennis Cabrera get a yellow.
Yeah, just dragged him down for the most part. Can't have any of that.
Step over by Carlton and taken away by FC Florida Prep on the break. Staying with it. And now lining up a shot from distance. And what a goal! From 45 yards out, Gabriel Almeida gets one back for FC Florida Prep. Are you kidding me?
Put that on the highlight reel. Absolutely phenomenal. He takes the ball away. He did it himself.
In the 53rd minute, FC Florida Preparatory Academy get one back from the U.S. Men's National Under-17 team on a wonder strike off the bar and into the U.S. goal. Unbelievable.
Well, that should jolt through the entire Florida Prep team. They really haven't had anything to celebrate about through the first 50 minutes of this game, with the exception of Alexander's play. And just like that, they've cut the lead in half.
Andrew Carlton trying the same thing, trying to catch the keeper off his line. And now you see a rejuvenated FC Florida Prep team. Touchdown, it will be a throw. That is going to be one anybody watching this game is going to remember for some time, especially number 11, Gabriel Almeida.
Well, you see the intensity start to pick up too.
Sticking with it, FC Florida Prep trying another shot from distance. Out wide to Trujillo, gets in, takes a shot in the corner and just tracks out and saves it from going out past the end line. And Garces now trying to shake off and whatever rust is. Florida Prep has not put a whole lot of pressure on them all game, so. And we talked about it early when they started taking some shots from distance. I believe we saw one from Sawyer Reese that just went over the bar. And you can't score if you don't shoot. Gabriel Almeida just proved that point.
Well, Garces his cage certainly has gotten rattled now, and I think the U.S.'s cage is now rattled.
Skipping through the box and out for a goal kick.
Well, now you hear it getting a little louder. Communications start going to become a priority for both teams. The United States has to be prepared now. I don't think they were expecting anything of that magnitude to come up and bite them. They're going to have to try and keep the pressure on.
Again, skips back out for a goal kick.
But I think they're going to have to take Florida Prep a lot more seriously now, now that they know that they can strike from that distance.
Now Carlton trying to fend off Sawyer Reese. Taken away, and Carlton wants a foul call. Trujillo cuts back. Now Goslin. And you can start to see now in the attitude of some of the U.S. players that they are slightly rattled by that wonder goal. Gloucester now trying to get that one back for the U.S. U-17s, trying to touch it up and through, and instead it is a throw-in. Isaac Anking. For Gloucester, just outside of the 18. Back to Anking. Approaching 9 o'clock local time, a little over 20 minutes remaining. 57th minute of play. Again, the clock will stop at 80 minutes. There will be some stoppage time added as FC Florida Prep looking for an equalizer. Goslin out wide, intercepted by FC Florida Prep again, looking for Trujillo. Running deep, Garces able to boot that, clear of the U.S. goal. Turn by Akinola. Sargent giving chase, booted back away by Wesley Alexander. Now you can see Trujillo trying to line up a shot, working his way through a few U.S. midfielders and defenders. Not happy, no foul was called. Now up for Sargent. Great touch, steps over, looking in the right wing, now into the center. And Carlton, beautiful touch, taken down, no call. Back into the corner. Chandler Vaughn able to win one back. FC Florida Prep looking for the equalizer. Lines up a shot from just inside the 18-yard box, and instead it's back to Gloucester with lots of space to run down the near side. Akinola now to the left wing. Gloucester was trying that overlapping run. Akinola trying to stay with it. And center referee going to say that Gloucester had a handful of the FC Florida Prep player's jersey. Akinola will take his time recovering. And they opt for the switch.
Well, Florida Prep has certainly had more possession in this half, far more than they had in the first half. And they've begun to also amp up the pressure on defense. They've certainly come out motivated.
Trujillo taken down, no foul. And Durkin able to draw the foul. Substitutions coming on for both FC Florida Prep. And we'll see George Acosta come back on. And that is Andrew Carlton, who is subbed out for Acosta. And we'll also see Chris Textor come off in favor of Luis Areola. Acosta looking to score his second goal in the last two nights. He was the lone goal scorer for the U.S. as they played the Tottenham Hotspur Academy this same time last night. Got one just in between Gloucester and Akinola. Out for a throw. Shoved by Almeida. Gloucester will have the throw. And that time, Josh Sargent taken down. And there will be some words. Almeida wants to have a couple with the center referee. And this will be Kareem Florville pleading his case.
Doesn't really have much of one. It pretty much took out Sargent while he was in midair.
Goslin back up to Sargent. Nice cutback and turn. Blaine Ferry. Give and go. Into the box. Ferry trying to get there, but Wesley Alexander diving to his right. Able to keep that U.S. attack out of the back of his net, and the score remains 2-1 in favor of the Baby Yanks.
Fantastic combination play, though. Nice job of carving right through the center of the Florida Prep defense. Just a little too strong from Ferry.
And now Gloucester having some words with the center referee as he jumped over a standing Gabriel Almeida.
Starting to see more acrobatics here. Maybe they have a second career in the circus if it keeps up.
And we are just about a few miles north of the circus capital of the USA. Now free kick for FC Florida Prep. See a little bit of frustration starting to set in on the U.S. players, even though they've got the lead, fighting for it in the box and tracked back to Justin Garces. Pressure coming from Areola. Up Acosta lets that one get away from him. Settled back to Alexander. And more contact in the middle. Give it back. 63rd minute of play. Acosta trying to keep possession for the U.S. Instead, FC Florida Prep will have a throw in their attacking half. Trujillo trying to get around Blaine Ferry. Now pressure coming from Acosta, one back by the U.S. Anking trying to get it up, and another foul. Anking is down. Waiting the free kick again. There's fatigue. These guys have played 3 to 4 matches in the last week, so some tired legs. We'll see some U.S. substitutions. Looks like Jalen Lindsay checking in for the U.S. That time, Chris Goslin And a wide open Gloucester charging down the left side. Goslin tries to bring it up through the midfield. Now set up, and they're going to say Anking was offside. Again, the U.S. now starting to get some more runs developing and try and get the ball forward to get that extra goal and regain their two-goal lead. Again, sometimes just a little over-eager in sneaking past that last defender.
Well, they certainly want to gain one back after the crazy goal by Almeida.
And now after some words with the center referee after that foul was called.
And in a way, the U.S. is trying to get two back because not just from the goal by Almeida, but Anking's penalty kick didn't go in either because of Alexander. So this game could very well be 3-0 at this point.
And if you're a fan of the U.S. youth national team, you have to hope that that penalty kick doesn't come back to bite them. As right now, they are holding their one-goal lead fairly firm, but dangerous set-piece opportunity coming for FC Florida Prep. Now into the box, Goslin gets a foot to it. Sent back to Clark Petrov. And the foul called against FC Florida Prep. It'll be a free kick for the U.S. And for FC Florida Prep, they're not just trying to impress possible future college coaches. This is also about trying to make a statement against the best in the United States. Goslin, nice touch up to Acosta. Give and go with Ferry. Trying to set up Anking, who is onside into the box, and again, Alexander with the save.
Anking was a little bit hesitant right there. He don't think he recognized the through ball just yet until it was well on its way past him. Had he been on time for that, he may have been able to put a shot off.
Durkin drops back to his keeper, Garces. Less than 15 minutes remain in regulation. If the score remains the way that it is, U.S. 2, FC Florida Prep 1. Goslin out wide. For Sargent in the middle, Akinola dribbling to his left. Great touch, great hop. Drop back to Goslin. Trading passes with George Acosta just outside the midfield circle. Sargent finds it, gets it over to Goslin. Tapped back to Gloucester. Pressure coming from Almeida. Now the U.S. will reset. Through to Sargent, who's onside. Cuts back, has an opportunity with his left foot into the box. Cuts back. And taken back away by FC Florida Prep.
Boy, he could have had two lanes right there to really fire away.
Akinola lines up a shot from distance, tries to curl it around the keeper, Alexander, but he is there to scoop it up. Florida Prep into the corner, into the 18-yard box, tries to get the cross through. An opportunity for Luis Areola, but out for the goal kick as we have some more subs coming for the U.S. We'll see Anking come off, and coming on for him will be James Sands, who saw some significant minutes last night out of Rye, New York, part of NYCFC's developmental academy out of Major League Soccer.
Well, on that last rush, it's been Trujillo, of course. We've seen him throughout the entire game as their main attacker, but now it seems like Areola is joining him. Those two may be the most threatening parties, the two threatening players that are seeking goals.
Acosta with Durkin. Looking for that long through ball. Onside. That was Jalen Lindsay. He shoved off the ball. The assistant referee allows play to continue, and now the assistant referee will whistle advantage. Up through for Goslin into the 18-yard box. Akinola lines one up and in. Goslin with the assist. And Ayamide Akinola with his second goal of the night. A brace in the 70th minute.
Well, that was all started by Jalen Lindsay. After the ball came through, it went right to Alexander. He gives it to his defender, and Lindsay tracks him down. And the United States has done a great job of that all night long, of not letting Florida Prep gain, and they didn't allow them to build. And once again, a quick strike right back in their own end, in Florida Prep's end, and Akinola just puts it home, and the United States is back up by two.
Wesley Alexander, again, been an amazing keeper for FC Florida Prep. That time just caught off balances. Akinola was able to sneak it to Alexander's left, and just no time to react as that curls inside that far post.
And I know no keeper would ever want to see three goals or be responsible for letting three balls go into their net, but it certainly is not on Alexander. He has certainly put his heart and soul into this game. It's just been a tough night for this Florida Prep defense to fend off the U.S. attack.
U.S. regain possession. Now Akinola. Back to Justin Garces. Ritaccio up for Ferry. And Goslin. Nice fancy pass now down the wing to Lindsay. Up front for Sargent. Onside, and what a save by Alexander. Beautiful shot by Josh Sargent. Tries to put it high, and Alexander able to get his gloves up and keep this a 3-1 game.
Boy, the vision, though, of this U.S. attack is just very impressive, very precise, very quick. They can certainly, they're certainly having a very good showing.
Gloucester up to Ferry. Akinola looking for his third of the night. Gets the turn and sent out past touch. That by FC Florida Prep. Be a throw in for Gloucester. Lane Ferry. Acosta tries to sneak one through to Goslin. Intercepted. Durkin able to get a foot to it. Settled back down by Jalen Lindsay. Garces now with room to step up and boot that back downfield. And Durkin goes down. FC Florida Prep trying to move the ball back forward, but unable at the moment, but now looking to counter. And a free kick. And it will be Durkin who will be shown a yellow card in the 74th minute of play. And a set piece opportunity for FC Florida Prep.
If Gabriel Alameda is hitting this, he's not. He's actually on the line right there, but based on what we saw, he can certainly strike.
Into the box, looking for Florville. Headed through. And taken away nicely by Sergeant Akinola. Shoved off the ball, fighting for possession. Had a wide open run, and Akinola with the takedown. And a yellow card is going to be shown to George Acosta. Did not give enough space. And after the yellow card is issued, now they will give the appropriate space, and FC Florida Prep, you can tell, even though they're down two goals, getting a little bit under the skin of this U.S. national team. Clark Petrov sends it toward the 18-yard box. Taken down. Almeida tries to spin. Gloucester mishits, looking for Akinola. Down the near side, instead goes out past touch for a Florida Prep throw.
Well, you got to admire, as you said, Ryan, with how much this team has stayed in and trying to fight. Didn't really show that in the first half for the most part. The U.S. was firmly in control, but a couple things here and there.
Now the cross to the far post and headed over the bar by Areola.
Things like that right there.
Looks like he might have had Garces beat, but not able to hit it square. Goes over the bar and out for a goal kick.
Just a little under the ball. A little bit under. He puts his head down, perhaps. Gets on top of it. He may have it sink or just hit that crossbar, and it goes in.
Goslin with a nice stop. Drops back to Durkin. Up forward for Ferry. Through the middle. Give and go with Sargent and Ferry. Under 4 minutes remain in regulation. I anticipate 2 to 3 minutes of stoppage time in this second half. Acosta has Gloucester. Dead run. Approaching the box. He's got Akinola. Tries to set him up. He's onside. Akinola misses the sitter. He was on. And out for the goal kick, and Ayamide Akinola just missing his opportunity. A wide open one at a hat trick.
Oh, people, sorry, you got to keep the hats on your heads for the time being. Yeah, he was wide open too.
Beautiful pass set up by Chris Gloucester. Beautiful spin to get it just up in front of the goal mouth, and Akinola just overthought it. And now a wide open Gabriel Almeida on the near side, waving his arms desperately, hoping for a pass. Forward interception. That one by LJ Lemmers. Through the box, trying to get in. Instead, taken back by Goslin. Couple options now for a charging Blaine Ferry. Looking for Akinola, who did not touch it. And offside whistled. As time winds down, final 2 minutes coming up. Acosta taken down, cleats up, and a straight red card for Gabriel Almeida. Goes two cleats up into George Acosta, an easy decision for any center referee, and he will go to the locker room. Almeida's going to have to spend the rest of the day, only a few minutes, and again, you can bet that right now Jalen Lindsay giving him a high five, congratulating him on the amazing goal that he had, but he is going to have to head out of the stadium until this game concludes.
Yeah, shame he has to leave the game, but that's what happens. You cannot put your cleats up. That is a big no-no in the world sport. But certainly, as the crowd gives him a hand, he certainly deserves that much. Fantastic goal, something I'm sure he'll remember for quite some time.
Something that I'm going to remember
yeah,
for quite some time.
I think all of
myself.
Us will. All of us will, for sure. certainly has a bright future.
Wide open left side, gets it up to Acosta and Gloucester. Overlapping run. It is Acosta looking for Gloucester in the box. Steps through, looking, and almost has Akinola again. Instead, it's out for a goal kick. And 4 minutes of stoppage time as the clock ticks over through 80. Goslin with some great dribbling. Another interception attempt. This one coming by Areola, now down that left side. Looking for Akinola. Great first turn, gets a tug, and the assistant referee is going to whistle it out. No foul, will be a throw-in for FC Florida Prep.
Well, down one man, they just want to keep the U.S. off the board again. Of course, they would love to tally on another point themselves. But the way this U.S. team has been able to dissect their defense, you want to at least fend off Akinola from getting a hat trick or at least another fourth goal being put on the scoreboard.
Pressure coming, looking for Akinola. Gloucester gets ahead to it. Now sent in that one. Efforted goalward, and that will be a foul against FC Florida Prep with time winding down. Now Garces stands over the ball. And the restart for the U.S. Back to Gloucester on the near side. Up for Goslin. Goslin steps forward, a beautiful through pass. Has Acosta into the box, tries to line up a shot, cuts back. Passes back for Goslin, lining up a shot again and deflecting wide. And out for a goal kick.
Right off the post, and it went on the inside. That ball, though, just did not want to trickle past the goal line. So close for a fourth goal for the U.S. team.
Actually, with some of the recent chances, it could have been their sixth. And jumping over the back of L.J. Lemmers will draw the foul every time. Now they're going to move everybody forward, sent into the corner. For either Lemmers or Florville. Now Gloucester and Acosta.
Oh, the man down, it's just so much tougher to hit those long ball passes.
Nice turn by Ferry. Akinola gets by one, tripped up. Ball will stay with the U.S. A little over 60 seconds remaining. Into Acosta. Nice little flick back to Ferry. Cleared back towards midfield. Possession being kept by the U.S., knowing that time is about to be concluded. Maybe one last rush. A turn by Areola. And that is the final whistle. And after an impressive performance by Ayamita Akinola, as well as the nice goal by Josh Sargent, Team USA will win this game 3-1 over FC Florida Prep Academy. And as good as the USA play, Trevor, those of you tuning in late, I cannot express just how fantastic the goal scored by FC Florida Prep and Gabriel Almeida booked late in the game. Back in the 53rd minute, though, to get one goal back and bring FC Florida Prep back within one. Just absolutely incredible.
I mean, that's one of the more spectacular goals, I would assume, for sure. I mean, amongst the younger teams that, of course, participated in this great event, that's certainly the goal of this super group. I mean, from that juncture. But admire the effort that Florida Prep gave despite being down early in this match. They fought hard. They felt they got better as the game went on. It was just too much pressure by the United States. They were just so fast, so crisp in their passing. Akinola was great, of course, with his goals. But it was just a very good effort by the United States. And Florida Prep, they did what they could, given what they had. And, of course, being down a man late didn't help either. But good efforts by both teams.
And thank you for sticking with us all evening long. The places for your 2016 IMG Cup, your champions, the Tottenham Hotspur U18 Development Academy, in second place, Deportivo Toluca and their U17 squad, and just winning the third place game, the Baby Yanks, the U.S. Youth National Team, their under-17 squad. And again, congratulations as well to making it this far to FC Florida Prep Academy against some very, very staunch talent. Want to thank you guys for tuning in. There will be other IMG Cup competitions outside of the Super Group for the next couple of days, but for everybody at Stream Sports and my broadcast partner, Trevor DeGroat, I am Ryan Sudol, saying so long and thank you for tuning in into the 2016 IMG Cup, presented exclusively by Stream Sports.